Hello and welcome to System Review number 2 for LoneWolf, the role-playing system. Joining me is my usual bunch of GMs. We've got Troy, Donovan, David, and a newcomer, Glenn, who will be joining us for this review of LoneWolf with its expansion. That's right. The author of the LoneWolf series got hold of us the other day, having watched our first review, and has very generously sent us the expansion, which launches, I believe, hopefully in June. So we have been privileged enough to have a look at this expansion, and we have to say we quite like it.
It's pretty sweet.
If you want to look at our full review, head on over to the other video, which is the actual review of this game. This is us playing it. We are going to pick up on where we were last time, so I'll give you a brief recap of what happened. In our first adventure, our plucky Kai lords, Wise Speaker, Kind Heart, and Sun Rain were instructed by the Kai Lord Silent Heart to go and investigate the keep that was run by Lord Cragen on the Taz Bay area in northern Summerland. There was suspicions of dark dealings going on. They proceeded to head into that territory where they came across some bandits, and that is where we left them. Our story picks up back in the Kai Monastery, where our Kai Lord
Initiate
in training is busy working with his companion
Skrit.
All right, so for our viewers, let us go through the table quickly and describe each other and ourselves, and, well, you get the point.
Right. All right, so I am a Kai Initiate, Fierce Sword, the trainee of Greyblade, the greatest two-sword master in the realm. I'm not that great, but hey, I'm working on it. That is me.
And your trusty companion?
I am Skrit, or known as Skrit.
Skrit!
Yes. The 2-foot mouse human...
Mouseoid?
Mouseoid, yes, that's it. Extra squishy.
If you ever played the Lone Wolf books, in book 2, you come across his race in the caverns underneath Hammerdal on your way to the Durinor Kingdom. Then joining us at the monastery as delegates from their place of origin.
From Desi, yes. Gaetano, the magician of Desi, will be joining the lot there in a good old silken and woolen robe. No armor to be found here. I tend to channel the energies of the planet and do so with either greater or lesser aplomb when I set things on fire, which I do like to do a lot.
I am playing Halo, a Varikos warrior mage, playing the bodyguard of Gaetano, just a humble bodyguard.
Who's amazing with two swords?
You could say
not
that
jealous.
So better than me. The great towers of the monastery are borne aloft into the blue sky and have stood proud for many, many decades, with, of course, the great mages of Desi having contributed to the construction of the monastery at its very founding. The day starts with a delegation of Desi arriving, led by our very own... and of course, now I've lost my notes. Where are they? Our very own Gaetano.
Gaetano.
You have been summoned to the Kai Monastery, or sent to the Kai Monastery, I should say, on behalf of the Desi, because there are rumours of trouble in the north. They just want to make sure that the Kai have got everything under hand, that there isn't something perhaps truly amiss. Your contact is a Kai Lord by the name of Silent Spirit, and you have been sent to discuss with him the matters at hand. The two of you are probably up to your usual tricks.
Training and keeping to myself with my companion.
Yes, me not so much the training, more looking around for the shiny bits to...
gather. Relocate.
Relocate.
Yeah, he does a lot of relocating.
Yes.
Of shiny bits.
Yes. To our quarters.
Which we share. Not as, master and pet, but friends.
Yes.
Friends.
I like that.
Of course.
Yes.
Yeah. Although he does sleep by the fireplace.
It's the best place.
Yeah. But anyway, yes, I'm training in the yard, doing my normal thing, trying to be the best next two swords master in the realm.
As you two arrive at the great doors to the monastery, you are greeted by a Kai Lord by the name of Greyblade. He is a particularly large man.
Fierce looking chap.
In about his 60s or so. And he has various blades strapped to his side. Although he is decked out in the traditional green Kai cloak. That marks him as his status in the monastery. I greet you, gentlemen, and thank you for your journey here. What brings the Desai to our humble monastery? And if you'll come this way, he says as he pushes open a door.
Greetings, Greyblade, and we have come to converse with Silent Spirit.
Yes. He has been troubled of late. Three of his acolytes have gone missing, and it is unfortunate when this sort of thing happens. We are, of course, preparing an expedition to try and identify what happened exactly. I'm hoping it's a breakdown in communications. But if you come with me, and he leads you through the venerable stone halls that contain Kai training
Can
and
I
practicing.
Can I see them going past, by any chance?
Not from where you are. The training ground is separate from the entrance areas, yes. He leads you through these various corridors, past rooms, there's various libraries and things. Nothing in comparison to what you have back at home, of course, but still fairly valuable nonetheless. You are led into a fairly large stone chamber where Silent Spirit is seated. He seems fairly agitated. Standing next to him is a young woman, dressed in a fairly simple brown one-piece type of tunic, although she does have a rather ornate gold headband that she wears. As you walk in, her eyes kind of glaze over, and you realize that she is communicating with Silent Spirit. I welcome you on behalf of Silent Spirit, Kai Lord of the Monastery.
That's why he never speaks.
Welcome.
I work it out.
We feel welcome, thank you.
Your presence is appreciated.
Thank you. I brought Halo along. He might look around a bit. He tends to do that.
The Desai are always welcome at the monastery.
Thank you very much.
What brings you here?
We received your message where you requested some of the Desai to come and investigate something for you.
We are pleased that you have sent such a grand delegation to investigate this with us. Three young Kai were dispatched along the coastal road near Tuz Bay some 3 weeks ago. They should have reported back by now, and yet there has been no response from them at all. The Kai lords felt it would be better to send a mixed delegation this time, simply because perhaps a different perspective would be beneficial.
Sounds curious. Do we know anything about the place where the three went missing?
Lord Cragen is responsible for the keep in that area. It is an independent kingdom, not affiliated with Summerland. However, it is allied with Summerland through various treaties which were signed over 200 years ago. He himself and his wife, Lady Tanley, have not been heard from in some time. This precipitated the first departure of the three Kai initiates.
Do we know where perhaps they went missing, or anything about their whereabouts at the time they went missing?
The Silent Spirit last reported seeing them departing along the road that would lead them directly towards the keep. A distance of 25 miles lay between Silent Spirit and the keep. It is assumed they are lost somewhere in that distance.
Great. Well, there's not much for it except going to take a look. What else should we know before going?
Lord Greyblade has assigned his novice acolyte to assist you in your endeavours. He travels with a companion of dubious quality, but of certain skills which may prove useful should any alternative methods of appropriation be required.
It seems the idea of a mixed crew is definitely well put together, but we always appreciate having somebody along, especially if they take good blows well.
She remains silent.
There we go.
You can come with me now, says Greyblade.
Thank you, Greyblade.
He leads you out into a rather large training courtyard.
The ringing of swords carries across.
Correct. There are novices practicing with blades, staves, spears.
But one looks particularly amazing.
And much older than the rest by about 10 years.
Yes, he has a full beard, unlike these other
18 and 16 year olds.
But that's the mouse on his face.
I am nowhere near that.
I have sixth sense, so I would sense my master.
Yes.
So I look across to the courtyard and see him with a delegation, sheathe my swords, and walk up to find out what's going on. I bow to my master.
Fierce sword, I want you and Skret to go with these two Desai mages and treat them with respect. They are allies and valuable companions.
Oh. Hello, did I hear correctly? Was that Skret?
Skret, he's my companion.
Right.
Childhood companion, if you will. Those are very impressive looking swords. But that's for another time. Master, I would gladly accompany them.
It is a simple retrieval or rescue mission, or even just a case of finding these three young Kai who have gone missing.
Very good.
Wise speaker, kind heart, and sun rain should not have come to any kind of harm.
Silent spirits acolytes who left 2 weeks ago?
Correct. They have not reported in, and we are concerned for their safety.
I did ask to be sent with them, Master.
Master Desai Mage, you will find Fierce Sword a eager companion on the road. Some temperance would go down well with him.
I am at your bidding. Master, may I ask why Silent Speaker hasn't gone himself?
There are other issues at foot which you are not privy to. Simply assume that Silent Spirit has his own motives and his own reason.
I will not disappoint you.
We all learn our ways only when we are on the path.
Correct. Allow me, and it's will. That way, he says, pointing to the great doors.
I will just go and get my companion. I'll meet you at the door. I say, and I bow, and I rush off to my quarters to find Skret. I burst in, Skret! Skret, the day has come! We're free from the monastery! We
I
can
have
go
whatever
exploring.
I have on the bed. I'll tuck it underneath the bed. There's nothing to see here. Yes, what's... Yes, sir.
Quick,
what
get,
can I help
get
you?
What you can. We're going. I told you. I knew it. I knew it. I had a feeling that something big was going to happen.
I will ask for rations for the travelling.
All right. Yes, the quartermaster will issue you with... there are four of you going, so he will issue you with 8 iron rations.
Shall we distribute those? Oh, he's all right
anyway,
to carry them.
All right, I grab things. I say, no, Skret.
No,
leave
wait.
That alone.
Yes.
No, you can't take that. Put them in a corner
this
in my cupboard. I'll be safe.
I lean over and grab random
How many
something
days
stick in my pocket.
It's about a week's travel. But it's there are little villages and things all the way along the road, right up to Tower Kalt,
okay.
Or Kalt. That Tower Kalt is the last outpost. Beyond that, it's then about a 4-day journey to the actual keep.
Since we weren't planning on traveling, can I pick up any lanterns, bedding, etc.?
Oh, bedroll, yes, absolutely. Remember, it
so
all does take space on your limited
Everybody
time
gets 3 meals. Just remember, a meal takes a back
I just need one as
correct.
A
3 meals.
Ten.
Yeah.
3 meals is 3 days.
So everybody would get, we got 8, so it's 2 each.
All right, a slightly over-eager Kai initiate comes jogging back up to the door with a little mouse creature. How tall are you?
Scurry up. 2 feet.
Yes,
two
a little
feet.
Mouse creature.
Scratching his
wrecked
ear. You notice he's missing a piece of his tail. But otherwise, all in good health and spirit.
2 feet tall.
Greetings. greeting.
I
church.
I bow to you. May I ask your name, my lord?
Gaetano.
Gaetano. Do I refer to you as my lord or Gaetano?
We are a few heartbeats beyond mortal. You may refer to me as you wish, but Gaetano will do.
Very well, my lord.
Scrit, scrit,
right,
scrit.
That's going to be a thing.
Scrit, I am Scrit.
Scrit.
Oh, yes, this scrit. Is my companion, Scrit.
Scrit, Scrit.
Scrit, Scrit.
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 Yes.
Scrit.
He's got a sure nose
scrit.
And...
It. Scrit.
Does it always repeat?
Get distracted by a chandelier or something in the distance.
Has my master's left us?
Yeah.
So we're just at the door of the monastery, hey?
Well, you have the rein of the monastery.
I have. I do have a horse, I'm right. Assuming, because I've got riding.
Yeah, you buy a horse?
Can I borrow a horse from the monastery?
Yeah.
Right. I'll be on foot.
We'll be walking.
They know what
all
you did
us.
With the last horse.
What? I like to gallop. You know, it might have... It wasn't...
It was already broken.
Yeah, it was already
broken.
Had issues. All right, so then we're all accounted for.
All right, so you head out on your journey.
Are we heading out on foot? I can't... did we come in on horse?
No.
No. Foot. Right. Foot.
Fitness, fitness, fitness.
Right.
Your journey takes you northwards through the little town of Isenore, then even further up into Hitchford. And then from Hitchford, instead of crossing the wild plains, you decide rather to head to Bear Beach and then from there to Amber Bay.
How many days?
This journey takes you about 6 days.
Oh, good.
But your food is supplied for at
yeah.
Every town you come to. The green cloak of the Kai guarantees a safe haven in any inn or tavern, and very few people are engaged in any kind of nefarious activities.
Yeah.
The four of you are, well, the three of you and you every now and again are very imposing individuals. While you,
so
I would imagine you'd ride up at an inn and you'd vanish to go and make contacts
and find stuff.
What do I pick up, seeing as I have the whole entourage to cover my whereabouts?
If I notice any...
Twitch. Make a perception check and you can make your stealth.
Sure.
Apparently I'm not as vigilant as I thought I might be.
Well, he
either
is a friendly
that or
mouse.
Scrit is a very experienced.
Let's say that
he puts on a cute look. You know, people oversee the hands.
Not good. This starts from one zero and works up, right?
No, it's only stats that I think are. Is it
So he's making a skill check.
Mm.
So what he does is your skills give you plus one if you have it. If it relates to a discipline or a knack or a whatever the
sure.
Case might be, that gives you plus three, and then you roll a d10.
The
if you don't have either,
yeah, what we're asking is just for reference.
Is a 10 a 10?
A 10,
oh.
Because we for the stats, it's a 10 is a 0.
Yes.
For
so
a skill, for combat, a 10 is a 10.
You did good.
For a skills, no.
A 10 is a 10.
Yeah,
I get 11.
11?
Yeah, I get plus 1 for my mousiness.
You managed to liberate on your 6 day journey without getting caught, because 11 is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
You managed to liberate 13 crowns from various people.
Do you
excellent.
Ever share your... No, it's actually best you don't share your findings with me, because I'm meant to stand up for truth and honour and such things. So
no.
We have an understanding. That,
yes.
Yes.
That it's really taxes for using all of our tunnels for so long.
You give him good cover.
Yeah.
I don't
ask
say anything.
No.
You don't ask questions.
Don't ask questions. Don't need answers.
To fund the better good.
So, Halo. Master Halo. That would be you.
Yes.
Your swords are very impressive. Would you mind sparring? I'd like to test your skills. I say this on an evening when we've made camp.
Go ahead.
Things are a bit quiet.
Should be interesting.
All right. Draw our swords and do you do your crazy disappear and reappear thing?
No. I'm taking it easy on you.
Oh, okay. I don't feel so bad now. Look at me. I'm doing good. I'm doing good at this.
Yeah, I've got a 3 point. Well, I've only got a 1 point
ahead
on you at the moment.
Oh, only 1 point ahead.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're actually.
So it's like,
we actually
I'm letting you, like, but you, you know, I'm.
Yeah. So if I exert myself, you're able to match me
yeah.
And turn everything, and I just can't land any hits on you.
Yeah.
Make your attack.
Oh, is that how it is?
Well, you can't spar and not.
Well, you're just not.
The average attack, so.
No, so please give me, what is your combat skill, Halo?
At the moment, 22.
Normally 25, currently 23. I'm
23? What's your combat skill?
21.
21. So the difference is...
So I'm on 26.
Plus 2.
26.
You're on 26.
Yeah, no, we're 21 plus 5.
Well, no, it's not how it works.
Give me your total combat score.
For this roll.
No.
Oh,
just flat, 21. 21.
Okay. Yeah. All right, so that means the differential is plus 2. That's your combat ratio. Oh. So between the two of you, one of you gets to roll the attack. Theoretically, it would go to Gaetano because you have the higher combat skill. So you're going
Well, Halo.
Okay.
Halo, sorry. Halo, yes. Thank you.
Seven.
Ooh. Oh, that's high.
Squid, does your master usually blue meet people that they want to fight?
He is
but testing I'm not trying to. Testing his I'm hitting the flats when Twitch. I when I do.
And I'm also playing with something metal in my pockets.
Roll
I tend to not take my hands out of my pockets often. Yes.
Okay, let's just say that you quite quickly overpower Halo. My defenses.
So Halo comes in with his blue blades.
Yeah.
And
so he's sparring.
He's holding back.
Yeah.
You make an aggressive move.
And he throws me
to
the ground.
Temper.
Yeah. And I don't lose my temper. I get agitated.
Yes.
That's all.
So
you lose your temper.
Yes.
Kai don't lose their temper. We have self-control and discipline. But I get mad!
And then there's you.
You get this neat chop on the back of your head. You take 14. You sort of swing out wildly at Halo.
And he's there and
like
claps me.
He just moves it aside. You take zero damage from that combat. Are you going to carry on?
Of course!
It's not physical damage. It is sparring damage.
Yeah, he sends me sprawling to the ground, which I, with cat's grace, I roll back to my feet. I say, that was a pretty fine move. I'm impressed. Let's try that again. I come charging in.
Perception check, please. All right, roll the d10. Either one of you, doesn't matter.
Okay, let me roll this.
Okay, you're at minus 2.
What do I add to that?
Oh, there we go. Hey, 7.
So if you've got any...
Minus 2 is 7.
Disciplines
not
disciplines.
I just give you the wrong number.
Traits
you
or skills that will add to your roll.
Well, it seems he can anticipate your maneuvers. You take 10 damage.
Oh, I come charging and crash into blades flying.
Minus
blades of glory!
But when you take the 14, just a reference, it's a minus your defense. So you actually took 9 in total.
Oh.
If you're doing a full combat, it'd be...
Okay.
What were your rolls?
6. 1.
This is because you're curled up next to the fire with your bag of cold crowns.
They're sitting in my pockets. I'm fidgeted with them. I'm fidgeting with them all the time.
Ah, that's what he's doing.
He's grin on my face, strangely.
How much damage did I do?
You, however, notice that while the sparring is going on.
The first one was 0 and you took 9.
You're being observed.
And then the second one.
There is a figure who's sitting. You are at an inn just outside of Amber Bay.
10 minus
where the sparring
eight,
is happening.
There
is a figure sitting
minus 8.
With
okay.
his hood up and he's just watching the sparring going on. Normally it wouldn't draw any kind of attention. Except that this isn't the casual indifference of a spectator watching two fairly good swordsmen go against each other. This is the bearing of someone who is working out their actual military prowess.
Mm.
Alright.
Squid.
Six sense?
I jump.
Or am I too engaged?
Yeah.
What?
Alright, no, you can
what?
Roll.
Okay. Plus two.
So I landed a good hit on him.
Mm.
He got me, I got him.
Fierce Sword, you take 6. You take 3, Halo, as basically he
6, I'm on
he gets
one.
You, but
yeah.
you're
we
starting to learn his manoeuvres.
Yeah.
So
we're actually starting to equalise a little
correct.
Bit. Yeah.
You still sort of spin around, you manage to just get a little bit on him,
can.
But nothing major.
Okay.
I use the gentle drawl of the Desai, which is very well understood or can be heard even when you whisper it. And I whisper across its script and I say, we are being watched. Would you go and see what that person's all about?
I look
you
around.
See a hooded figure watching these two quite intently.
Put my nose to the air and...
He smells like sea and salt with a bit of sweat from horses.
Using my nose for trouble. Don't you love that description?
That's a lovely description. Yes?
Twitch, twitch, sniff, sniff, twitch, mm-hmm. sniff. Do I... Is it human? Is there metal on him?
Is it a is that a that's a power that you have?
Mm.
Okay.
It's yeah. That's one of my.
He's definitely human. Okay. He was recently involved in combat, and he definitely has something. Is it? You've taken a big sort of breath. You can smell. Kai on him, but not very strong.
Okay. Mm. How recent combat is he still bleeding?
He isn't bleeding, but there's definitely blood on him.
Okay. Mm. Is there a way to approach him from the side or behind?
Yes, the little inn that you're staying in is not very well lit, and the flames from the hearthstone are from the hearth are busy sort of throwing out these shadows.
Are we fighting outside in the courtyard?
Well, the way that the inn is designed is that it's a three-winged affair, and the tavern part has an outdoors area.
Yeah.
Which is where everyone's sitting.
So we're just kind of putting on a show for people in many ways. So there are people drinking around watching
us. Correct. Well, there's not a lot of people here. There are, there's the barman, obviously. There's a serving wench, and then there's four other travellers. And then this individual.
And all are quite engrossed in this display of swordsmanship, I imagine.
He is. The four travellers, yeah, they're also, they seem to be sliding coins between each other as to who they think's going to go down.
I look up at you with a little grin in my face, and I scratch my ear and I go, cover me, and I disappear.
How many did you take that last one?
One.
Okay, also one. Back to you.
All right, we're circling each other, because we've kind of worked each other out now. And I come in with my super feint, which Greyblade taught me. Go for the groin! Hurrah! 10. Groin shot!
That does catch you totally unaware. This is not the regular styles of anybody.
It is called slippery groin shot.
I just invented now.
I just got it. It came to me.
Yeah. That hurt. I'm going to teach him.
Like a hoyata!
At which point I just jack it up a notch. I'm going to pop behind him and...
What did you take there?
What did you take? Eight. You took 0.
You took 8. Wow, you minus 17. Mm. Okay.
So I'm almost down.
So literally now it's like just appearing behind.
Yeah, just like teleporting.
Okay.
Hey, where'd you go?
5.
All right. So what are there any mechanics for that teleport?
No, from a combat perspective, it just gives me a +2 to combat.
Yeah,
okay. So
it's just like literally now I'm like.
I know. Well, then that's fine. But that's now activating. Yeah. So your combat ratio is going to change.
Yeah.
Because now you're changing from 23 to 25. Yeah. So your difference is now 4, and you rolled a 5.
Yeah. I think this just got real.
Literally, you vanish from where you are.
All right, appear behind
it. It's on.
Fierce sword, you are about to strike,
and it is thin air.
Just thin air, but...
No, well, I didn't get him. I got him good.
Well, in your swing, you realize that he's behind you. No, so you carry on.
Oh.
And you sweep low.
Yeah.
So you catch Halo in the back of the leg.
Double blow! Low blow! Swing round! Low blow!
Unfortunately, his blade also clips across your shoulder.
Not so good.
For a lot more damage. You take 5, Halo, you take 4.
Oh, I took naught there.
Yeah, that...
It glanced off my armor.
Yeah.
You took?
Two.
Right, back to you two. What are you two doing?
I Squid has scuttled off, and I'm watching to see if anyone notices Squid scuttling off so that I can provide some 21. Cover.
So you're on negative 19.
Keep in mind that the tables are here.
Yes, no one has seen you doing anything.
Great.
Okay. Sorry, look.
Plan to pop up next to the man.
When Fierce Sword gets into the zone.
And using my other skill, which is Patchwork Tinker.
He's got a slight glaze over his eyes.
His clothing, what boots he's wearing.
Not a very well trained kind.
Just how
trainee.
He, things like that. I want to know, is it a Kai hood that he's wearing? Is that what I smelled, doing all that sort of stuff?
Okay, so you kind of assessing him out. His boots are covered in mud, and it seems to be a fairly light-colored mud.
Okay.
Light sand obviously was involved. There is some bits of broken leaf matter stuck to the soles of his boots. Otherwise, he's got a rather large pouch, satchel thing that hangs around his shoulders.
Okay.
His cloak is fairly well worn. Okay. And he has two very nasty looking, very curved blades that remind you more of a Vasagonian weapon than anything that would be found up here in Summerland.
Interesting. Any other strange features now that I can see him close up?
He just looks like a fairly well-worn kind of individual who's been out in the sun quite a lot.
Okay.
Mm.
I'm going to take a chance. I'm going to pat him on the pouch because I want to see if it's full of gold or something shiny or metal. And go, like what you see.
So you're saying that to him?
Yes.
Like what you
and look
see.
He's like, what is charming that? And friendly, like.
Okay. I mean, I wouldn't resist that cute mouse.
I look like I've just crawled out of the sewer, but hey.
Wow. What is your combat skill?
Ooh, not great. But that's what the will is for. I also have, that's why I'm twitchy, is a rat reflex or rodent agility.
Uh-huh. And what does that
do? So I will use those to, the description was for speed and reaction. So if a trap triggers, I have a chance of actually escaping it by reacting faster than it
All right, triggers. And how do you calculate that?
It doesn't have, it's in my, what they call knacks.
Okay.
So it's in my
personality. So you can just trait like a discipline for.
Yeah. Well, that's good. Okay. So what happens is you kind of, as you pat him and say, like what, before you even see, finish the word,
like
see,
what?
His hands have pulled those daggers out and he's basically bringing them straight towards your head.
Okay.
Which allows you to leap back.
Yeah, can I do that like
four steps?
Friend.
Don't touch friend. My bag, rodent.
Sure. I'm just being friendly.
I know you're kind. Be gone.
How?
Hey, can rude. I get Sixth Sense and see this guy drawing blaze on my friend?
No, because you're involved in this combat. I'll come to you now.
Yeah, how rude. I twitch and wander off, disappear under the first table.
Back to you two.
Okay, well he's
now
comes,
teleporting.
Yeah, he teleports, hits me on the back. I tuck and tumble, stand up, so you attack again while I'm getting my balance again. I'm taken off guard.
Oh.
you're still like, low blow.
Well, as you're rolling up, you kick out
and
hit him in the shin, which bends your whole knee.
Yeah.
You take six.
Oh, that's put you down. He drops.
I'm down.
Are you down?
Yeah.
As I drop and roll, I kick and then roll up and then stand up and he drops down. And then I kind of get out of my glazed sort of crazy and I'm like, maybe I took that a bit far. I go and give you my hands.
Get up.
I lift him up. I'm like, sorry, I tend to go a bit crazy sometimes. But that was amazing. Well done. You got to teach me your stuff.
There is a large amount of grumbling coming from the four companions at the table, and you see large amounts of coin. Well, by large amounts, I mean you see five coins being shunted over to the other two who are sitting there looking very smug. One of them raises his hand, and a round of ale is ordered for all of you, courtesy of
the I help you to a bench because you kind of got a sore knee now and a sore crotch. You're like,
sorry. The lone figure gets up and leaves.
Oh, also want to find out accent.
His accent, do you have the skill? Sorry.
No.
Do you have investigate?
I do.
Yes. You heard him because he
I would have heard him, yeah.
Yes, both of you can make that skill check.
Oh!
Make Same. That a 10.
Wow. Okay, as Nine. A master linguist, you understand that his accent, there's a type of person who they're known as tower, some call them tower brats, some call them towerlings. They're basically a very small community of people who grow up around what are called the towers. And there are various towers scattered along the Derncrag Mountains, which separate Summerland from the Darklands of the Helgadad and that kind of thing.
Is one of them Kurzanar?
No, Kurzanar is a town and is the reciprocal tower to, and is the Dark Lord's tower. To the Summerlands Tower, basically. Okay. It's an observatory. They're making sure there's no armies coming through. But the Towerlings often, they grow up as very small, very defensive communities because they're right on the edge of society. And their dialect just happens to be one that you've heard before. So he is definitely from a tower. The closest tower is the tower that you're heading towards right now, which is the Tower the Cult. He might be from there, but you can't tell specific towerlings. They, of course, can. Sure. But, you know.
Because they all look the same. Okay. I turn once, because I disappeared under the table, just to check if he was... Oh, you said he left.
He gets up and leaves. As soon as the fight finishes, he kind of pushes up, gets up, walks past the bar, chucks a crown over.
Watch to see if he's limping or favoring a side
He does seem to be walking like someone who is very experienced with being aware all the time. You suspect you probably would not be able to get the drop on this guy in the slightest.
Most important, is he walking like the bag is heavy?
There's a jingling.
It's a very good question. He's walking like the bag is actually fairly light. It's quite puffed out.
Sure.
But it doesn't seem like it's got very much weight to it.
Change of clothing, perhaps? Well, give it a couple of feet and then I'm going to walk and stand on the entrance to see if he takes a side road or if he walks down the main road.
Okay.
And start following him from there.
Being insightful and with Investigate, was there anything else that I sort of picked up out of his demeanor and the way that he behaved?
Not so much in his demeanor, but in the way that everyone else behaved. He's obviously a regular here. Okay. Or if not a regular, then certainly people have seen him before. Certainly the barkeep didn't demand that he paid for his beer before he drank it. So that shows a certain amount of trust. From his observance of the fight and his reason for leaving, there wasn't enough from him to determine he left because they finished fighting or he left because he finished his beer.
Fair enough.
I'm stretching. You're realizing that my arrogance might have cost me a fight.
I bring you a beer. Do you drink?
No.
Oh, I'll have two.
Are you going off
and
after
I give
the
Kai a bad name?
No, I was just going to stop at the doorstep to see.
Beer.
I'm going to.
Follow to talk to you as well at the doorway to hear anything else you might have sniffed off of him.
Where is my rat anyway? I'm looking for a beer. I'm looking around for my rat.
Looking, but everybody, I'm like, he's here somewhere. If I trip over,
is
right now,
my mouse?
Yeah.
Is my mouse?
Oh well.
Eventually, you see him at the doorway with the mage.
I actually feel quite embarrassed because I got crazy. So I just walk up to the door. I'm like, well, that was embarrassing. I give my mouse and
take it with
beer.
Both my hands. Maybe I should sit down.
I'm like spilling over his cheeks.
So because of my stature, poison and potions are twice as effective.
Well, I've got healing, so I
might
can
be
detect
out of,
poisons and potions.
Out of action.
So. Just make sure I drink it first, and then you're okay.
Yeah. The beer's going to knock it.
Yeah, beer's going to knock me. So I take a couple of glugs and go, I have some business before I pass out in the next 10 minutes.
It's just like drinking maybe four large ales.
Yes. Yeah. In the space of 5 minutes.
Before you've had that sip, though, I will ask you what you managed to sniff off of the character.
New battle. Strangely enough. Twitch. Mud, light, a kind master, but he is not one. Twitch. And I wander off, still mulling over the information in my head. Like this, so people can see me. I'm going to the barman.
I look to Fear Sword and I say, he's quite useful, that little one, actually.
Oh, yes, I keep him at my side all the time. What exactly... Did something happen that we missed while we were fighting, or...
Your hijinks seems to have attracted a little bit of attention. There's someone who looks like one of the tower people that was around. Your handy little friend seems to be getting terribly inebriated quite quickly.
I'm trying to get the
there's not much
jug on top of the bar, but I'm struggling because it's still another foot.
Walk over, pick it up, put it down.
Yes. He has a habit of getting into the wines at the monastery.
Right.
Yeah, he's closely watched.
He did manage to pick up that it seems there might have been some brawl between that character and one of your Kai brethren. Probably a good reason for us to have a chat with him at
some
stage.
Where did he go?
He popped out the door. It seems like he was heading back to wherever it is that he came from. But he does also seem to be well known here, so we might be able to ask.
Why don't we just track him down right now while the trail's hot?
How's that looping? And are you willing to give
he'll
up
be
your
fine.
Wait until I stretch out, feel like I'm, you know, walked off this.
I mean, I'm feeling good for another fight.
Jumping my heels, apparently, because...
Yeah, sorry about that. I learned it in the fighting pits. What can I say?
Yeah. I have probably by now sluggishly climbed up onto the bar stool, leaning over, using my drunk influence to the barman, saying, "Can I ask you a question?" Twitch, twitch.
We don't get a lot of your folk this far out.
I know, I'm special.
But you're welcome to ask questions, go for it.
That guy, I might have offended. Who is he? Who is he? Who is he?
Oh, that's Kashkin.
I see, leaning forward, hoping he'll get that I want more information from.
He slides a very small tot of whiskey over towards you.
That will be six gold.
I put my arms around the beer. That's fine. Who is he? Tower.
He's one of the Towerlings, hey? Tower Occult.
And
fairly regular in town. Good bloke in a fight. Quite reliable. Doesn't talk much. Bit twitchy.
Twitchy. What do you mean? him. Oh. Anything I should know?
About?
Ruffle around in my pockets, pull out a coin. Play with it a bit.
About?
Look, swing around, look for my friends, see if they're still in the bar, how much time has gone by.
I'm trying to...
I laugh at the mouse because I'm standing right next to him.
I'm behind him, so he's like...
So there's everyone gathered behind you.
I'm still sitting in the corner drinking, wondering why everyone's gathering around the bar.
I was the one who helped his up with the beer mug, so I'm just looking after him because that's what happened.
Yeah. I am precariously leaning up against the bar, so everyone's like
people doing it around me. There's so many of them.
What do you want to know exactly?
Well, family, influence.
About Kashkin?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
I think what my furry fellow is struggling so eloquently to get towards is he a good sort or a bad sort?
Kashkin's been part of the Tower Occult for about 20 or 30 years. His family's been in that tower since they built it. I wouldn't think of a more reliable family in all of Summerland than the Kashkins.
And who would he be loyal to?
What, you mean like the king?
Yes.
Well,
the king.
The king.
Good that.
Shrug my shoulders, look around, see how far I would fall if I have to get off this.
Not far, because there's a whole bunch of hands on both sides of the bar. You've got him behind you and the barman in front of you, all kind of moving as you wee.
Are we moving along?
Okay, I go to the bar and I pick up my friend. I say, we need to talk.
I grab the...
You go sit down in the corner and say, look, whoever this guy is,
I've still got a coin in my fingers, by the way.
If he's an enemy of the Kai, the longer we wait, the longer he has to get away or inform people about us, which seems to be perhaps his, you know, purpose. So
you're
let's
very
track
paranoid.
Him down. Yes. Yeah. And let's kill him.
It's not a good thing.
Or apprehend him and ask him questions and then kill him.
You seem very thoughtful.
Yes, I've been meditating in the corner with a beer while you guys are all at the bar.
Well, he's a member of the Tower of Cult, so I'm sure he'll be heading in that direction. Which direction would we go as we head out the door, Innkeep?
Just a reminder for everyone, the towers are defensive things against the darkness. They're good people.
Yes.
But he's not. We must kill him.
Down what's left of the...
Well, he's recently had a brawl which involved a Kai. So.
And there are three missing Kai initiates, one of which was not my friend. We need to find him.
We haven't worked out which one yet. Okay, so should we in keep which direction?
We're the Great North Road.
Oh, there will be no talk of murder.
Great.
I never murder. I don't murder. I apprehend. I judge. I execute. Guilty people.
So I walk towards the door and look in their direction meaningfully, step out the door and start to walk.
Yes, I, with him. Come on, I pick you up.
Plug down the last bit. I put it, try, put it down. And yes.
I make sure everybody leaves.
The people I've ever seen in this inn, that's for certain.
Hit him on the chest, go, put me down. Just put, I can walk. I can, think I can walk.
I just carry him over in my arm as usual.
Oh,
we catch up with Kitano and we make for the Tower of...
Well, we're heading north and seeing if we can spot Kashkin.
Well, as it so happens, the Tower of Cult would have been your last stop anyway.
What is the time now?
Correct.
It's about... 4 o'clock? No, you stopped it was in the evening, so it was about 10:30.
I'm not afraid of the darkness. I've got tracking and I've got hunting, so I'm trying to... Have I seen anything when we left the inn in any way, like moving in this direction? No. I mean, it's cobalt streets and it's hard to track, but...
Mud streets. This is the last town of civilization.
So can I see any footprints of any form?
It's very easy to follow.
Oh, well, then I'm following.
Left the inn and headed straight up the Great North Road. Footprints. He hasn't tried to hide it in any way.
All right, let's make speed as far as we can. Try to catch up with him.
The four of you make your way along the road, and it isn't long, possibly an hour, before you come across a very obvious campfire on the side of the road. There seem to be three figures sitting around it, while one of them is sleeping, and the other two are sitting, it looks like they're playing cards.
How sober is the mouse?
Yes, if he hasn't put me down, I'm probably sleeping.
Yes.
Yes.
That's what.
So we stop at some distance from them when we see the fireplace. Strategies?
Walk up and hoe the camp.
I like you, brother. I like you. When you say hoe the camp, like chop them to pieces. Is that what you said? Is there a communication thing? Okay. What did you say? I don't think I got the accent.
I'm not helping you. I'm just going to let this slide. It's way too...
Put me down.
Way too...
Wait, I've been carrying you all the time. All right, well, I will go and confront him. I'm the Kai Initiate, and I am the bearer of justice.
You're not a very good Kai Initiate.
Well, I have to learn somehow, so let me start here. Now...
If you attempt to harm innocent beings...
They are definitely not innocent. At least I assume so, yes?
Your assumptions...
Right.
We'll get you killed.
Oh no, I will be the bearer of justice and order and such things that Kai do. Just observe. Gentlemen, I say, and I make towards the camp, trying to not be, you know, unobvious.
I used to be walking towards the camp. I don't know, did he put me down softly or did he
Yes, I put you down and I was having a discussion with him about justice and order and execution and things.
Curl up into a ball.
No, what?
Okay. Because I'll follow behind our headstrong Kai, I'll nudge the mouse and say, we've arrived.
You would know that.
Jump up with my rat reflex and Rona's agility. Go, what did I miss?
You see the Kai
marching with a sense of purpose in his stride.
Towards the fire.
Towards the pie.
Mm. Gather myself until he's not too far away and then I scurry towards him.
Okay. And you're following behind him?
Muttering.
Right.
No muttering.
In your head there's muttering. I see it on your face.
If you have any kind of, like your sixth sense might be tingling that if you do anything stupid...
There will be trauma from behind.
Oh yes, no, I realise this. My sixth sense knows that. But I have to prove myself of worth as a Kai who brings justice and order to the world. So I walk into the light. Looking all imposing.
Well, as you start approaching them, the light is flickering about. The one sitting facing the direction you're approaching stands up. You're probably about 50 feet away.
Yeah. I haven't got weapons drawn. I'm just walking up with a meaningful step.
Greetings, strangers on the road.
Greetings, I say, carrying on walking forward.
Ho the camp.
Is he saying ho the camp or hold the camp? I can't get his accent. What's he saying?
Ho.
Ho, as in ho ho.
Arr.
You guys come from a different part of town. I don't get your accents. Okay. I don't know what they're on about.
It's a long and weary road to be travelling late at night.
He's not stopping us walking up to him, eh? So I walk up to him and I say, greetings, I'm looking for one known as Kaskin.
The one with his back to you stands up, turns around. You see the daggers as before.
I stop next to him, hold on to his pants and catch my breath. And then I see him stand up and I sort of go a little bit behind him. So that, you know, so I'm looking at him like through the side of his pants.
I'm Kaskin.
Kaskin, I look him up and down.
I should warn you.
What is my sixth sense telling me about him?
Nothing.
Ah, I hate my sixth sense when it tells me nothing.
I should warn you, if you're bandits, we'll arrest you and take you into town.
No, I've been told to find you.
At this point, I'm...
Apparently, you might have information for us. Do you mind if we join your circle? And share your firelight?
Yeah, you travel with a thief.
Oh no, don't worry about him. He's really more just entertainment.
I disappear more behind him.
he's strictly just steps entertainment. Back. He's my pet. I just pat you.
I kick him.
As I said, he's my pet. Now, no stealing anything. We're going to be friendly.
My hands are in
okay.
the back of my pocket.
Now, may we join your fire?
To try and distract the issue as well, I'll step forward in my silk and woolen robes and I'll go, Master Kaskin of the Tower Cult, we need your assistance.
You know I'm from the Tower?
I do, yes.
All right, you may approach.
All right, well, we walk in around the fire. I say, it's a simple matter. We're looking for three Kai initiates who went missing. I believe you might know something. I won't disclose my sources, but... I've been told perhaps you're the man in this area who knows things about things and might be able to help us at a good price.
Are you trying to bribe me?
No, I'm trying to buy your services as a man of information.
Are you sure this man is a Kai?
I don't believe so.
I'm not sure this man is a Kai.
I was going to report something to you lot when I saw you at the inn. Only then I reckoned I wasn't dealing with someone from the monastery. But a pack of thieves had stolen a cloak like the one I found the other day.
Okay.
Sorry. Shut up. You mentioned a cloak that was missing?
Aye. He pulls out a green Kai cloak from his satchel, chucks it on the ground in front of you.
Do I recognize it from one of the Kai?
That's definitely Kai.
But one of the initiates? Would I be able to tell?
It's a green.
Okay.
Just pick it up, check for like damage.
It's torn in several places. There is quite a lot of blood on it, on both sides.
I'm sniffing.
Definitely smells of Kai. Make a wisdom check. Willpower check.
Yeah. Not bad. I get in minus one though, right?
Mm-hmm.
6.
You recognize the smell of Kind Heart.
Kind Heart? No. Oh.
Yeah, so I say, Kind Heart. It must be his.
Was I particularly close to Kind Heart? Oh, he was a friend. He was a friend. I take his cloak and I look at him. Where did you find this?
Out on the road. Couple miles north of the tower.
Could
well,
you take
west
us there?
Of the tower, actually. Aye, I might.
Good. Anything we find, you're more than welcome to share the booty.
How far were you from Craigan Keep where you found this?
The shiny
just on the outskirts.
No!
Being from the tower cult, do you know anything about the Craigan Keep?
Only that they've been gone quiet these last few weeks. Patrols have done nothing unusual. Only there ain't no hunting out there. It's barren, which is unusual. Usually it's quite busy. Only there's been strange folk about, haven't there? Asking strange questions of the watchtowers.
Mm. Can you help us with any other specific information that might help us find these Kai initiates who went missing?
You mean apart from the fact that I found the cloak several miles away from the tower on the east road, on the west road?
That, exactly, yes.
Fear that during some of the sparring, my companion might have taken a few blows to the head.
Possibly one.
Thank you for your assistance. May we...
You may share the camp for certain, but I'll be watching someone.
I'm actually watching his companions. Do they react at any point when he speaks about where he found cloak or helping
They're
us?
Mainly just... Well, there's only one other one who's awake. The other one who's asleep is still snoring soundly.
Okay.
But the other one who's awake is just shifting his view from... They all dress in a similar kind of garb.
I'm going to use my sixth sense with this question. So I look at him one more time and I say, you are certain you know nothing more about the disappearance of the Kai. Sixth sense.
When I tell you I found the cloak, I found the cloak.
But you know nothing more.
No.
Right.
It was hanging on a tree branch as if discarded.
Would you like to spar
again? Right, that's all
again?
I have to ask, I say. And I go and sit down at my place.
He's thorough that way. I hop over and sit down next to him.
Apologise.
Did they send three of him up onto the... check the castle of Lord Dragon?
I have never met a Kai initiate with...
such amazing skills. Yes, I know. Sorry, that's OOC.
Okay. We don't know.
I'm surprised they managed to get that far without killing themselves.
Or being killed for...
other reasons. Bribing a tower watcher is not a very good defense.
Wasn't bribery!
Alright, well, the
we
night is...
each other.
The night has passed fairly uneventfully.
Okay, so my sixth sense absolutely picked up nothing.
Nothing.
Okay.
No malice.
The next morning...
There's a lot of malice.
Yes, there's tension.
The next morning when we set off, which I assume we do without any other things.
There was no hitch.
No, we'll set off.
I come up next to you and I say, you see, the Kai brought justice and wisdom to that scenario. There's no need for justice. Thus, we can now go and apply justice to the true killers of the Kai Nations.
Are the people of the tower also travelling north, I would assume?
There's only one road to the tower and that's the road you're all on. So right. They'll walk with you. Although they do
a true hero jumping on the horse.
Eventually, you realise they're actually walking quite a bit faster, trying to get some distance.
Right. Okay.
What do you think of the situation, Skrit?
I'll try and match their pace.
Yeah.
Skrit seems to be a bit wobbly today. But
do you need a carry?
No. I'm fine.
Twitch. All right, so we follow on towards the tower.
Okay. Would who has tracking? I think you've got tracking. Anyone else got tracking?
No.
Oops. No?
Yep.
Okay. The Tower of Kalt itself, named after the area that is to the northwest of you, and the Great Kalta Sea. The tower itself is relatively unimpressive. There is very little chance of the Dark Lords using this particular area as a site of invasion. The ocean which crashes down below is not a nice beach. It is a rock-strewn, cold, bleak area. And what little sand there is seems to be very muddy and boggy. So, as
but it's a picture of freedom. Freedom from the monastery, Skit. This is what adventure's all about.
Keep telling him.
I'm not too sure he didn't have a sip of his mead first thing this morning.
Other than that, there's a small little village that's sort of sprung around the tower. The tower is about 3 stories high. It's been reinforced multiple times with different architectural styles, as it's kind of basically been forgotten about. But the road ends here.
So where's the east road that he was speaking of if it ends here?
Well, you were speaking of the West Road, but...
He said East Road!
Didn't he also just say it was X miles north of
I
the tower?
East.
Not necessarily a...
Northwest.
Yeah.
Which side of the head did you hit him on? Because I think he might need a whack on the other side.
Bring him back.
The back side of the head.
Forehead next.
So, Kaskin will he takes you to the sort of the edge of the village and... You can see that at one point there might have been a wall that had been constructed, almost cutting off the coast, from the coast to the mountains which stretch up. But they started building with gusto, and then they realized that the distance is probably about 1.5 miles. So the wall is only 500 or 600 yards long. It's still quite impressive, but
sort of peters out on both ends. There's no one coming to attack us from here. On the other side is this cart track, which winds its way towards the west. That's the road up to Lord Craigan's place.
Thank you for your service. And
about 5 miles yonder, you'll find there's a small wood. In that wood, that's where I found the cloak hanging on one of the trees.
This would be the last place where we can get any provisions if we need anything.
You might struggle to find here too. That's what I was doing in town, picking up provisions.
If we hadn't left earlier, we could have probably gotten some in the town, but...
Your help has been invaluable.
At least we still have our iron rations.
Yes, we haven't used that yet.
Mm. No, not at all. Mm. Okay, so you continue along the...
We go on the
track road.
Quest.
Yes.
Quest.
The journey is going to take you about 2.5 days to get to the actual castle itself. And the track road continues. Eventually, you get to... It almost looks like you're in a different province, because as you crest over a rather large hill, in front of you, you can see a very dense wood which stretches quite away. And then way off in the distance, this is on the end of the second day of journey, you see jutting out into the Tuz Bay this massive towered castle. It's got battlements and things. There's banners flapping on the wind on each of the towers. And there's a small village directly in front of it.
Do any of us have a map?
No.
We weren't supplied with a map. So
it's not too hard to find. The road does a bend, and as it bends around, you see that there's a large boulder on the one side of the road and some scrub bush on the other. And there appears to have been some sort of battle here.
I'll go and investigate.
Bloodied.
How many people are involved in this battle by tracking?
You think there are about 4 people that died here, and then several others moved around, but in total there are about 6.
Okay, I report that to the rest of the team as I look and feel around.
I'll look insightfully at the sort of area, and I would say if I was a bandit of sorts, this would be the kind of place I would try and set some sort of trap for people.
Correct. Do you have investigate?
I do.
Make a check.
Ha! 10 again.
So this looks like it was an ambush, but it looks like it was an ambush of an ambush, because these figures were all clearly waiting, and then they came rushing out to confront something, and then 2 more figures came down the hill through the forest and came into their side, and then the battle sort of ensued, and that seemed to be quite a violent battle.
So if tracks came down from the forest, should we not investigate in that direction?
I have a sense that this was some small thing, because we've got tracks that leave here.
No bodies?
So follow the tracks that leave.
Mm. No bodies?
There are four
skeletal, like rotting, stinky corpses.
They've been picked clean by various small scavengers and things. The dress is very haphazard, so you would hazard that these were bandits.
Okay. Whoever fought the bandits won this battle.
I'm going to use a combination of my investigate and my nose for trouble.
Sure.
Just to pick up if the Kai were here, if they were involved, things like that.
It's very, very easy. Okay. There were definitely 3 Kai warriors involved.
My friend Kai
was here. You can
see
from the controlled steps of the movement versus the chaotic, heavy-booted creatures that they were fighting.
Can I make a check to see if I pick up the movements of Sunrain, who was the best fighter of our age group?
At the sure. Perception
no.
check?
No. Not so perceptive.
No.
It's just a mass of footprints.
It is. It is.
Can I pick up the different scents?
No. It's been several weeks since that happened. It has rained and there's...
Yeah.
Etc. Yeah.
Okay. I pick up a bit of Kai spice.
Mm. But there is that trail that leads away from where the fight happened.
Sure.
Something came down the mountainside and then moved up into the forest.
Yeah. So, suggestions?
Follow the trail.
I'm really sniffing my way
That's
up the
very
road.
Logical.
Okay.
We follow the trail.
Sniffing. Well, he's already left.
Oh, I'm
sniffing. Come back. Sniffing my way up the mountain.
Twitch.
I seem to like this little mouse. I follow the mouse.
He's a good mouse.
Okay, dokes.
So you make your way up the pathway.
I'm also smelling in case there is an ambush ahead.
Right, so there is definitely something ahead. It smells like pork.
Ooh, I like pork.
That's gone rancid.
I don't like that.
So like,
and it's very strong aroma. And then it smells like oil. So it's this very nasty, tallowy kind of aroma. And then very metal-like.
When I walk up to him, do I get sixth sense for anything in this area?
So I won't stop because he's my curiosity is so my curiosity. Just the smell of the pork is a little bit.
Okay. You then, yeah, that's kind of the aromas that you're getting.
I check over my shoulders to make sure that I've got back up.
They're coming up the hill behind you. Yeah.
I'm not running off ahead and they've forgotten about you.
No.
Okay.
You come up into a clearing. Make a perception check.
Would I add to that or not?
If you have perception
skill, you'd add one.
No. So six.
Six. All right. You kind of come up into the sort of area. You can see that there was a camp here once long ago. There's some stones that were arranged around a fireplace, and there's what looks to be some very old lean-tos that have just been left to grow. But as you come to a stop, stepping out from behind these large boulders that have sort of strewn down the mountainside, are four very large individuals dressed in very black armor.
I think we can kill them.
The armor is decorated with lots of spikes in certain places and hooks in other areas.
Definitely.
So it looks like what they are quite fond of doing is either embracing their victim and then letting them die on the hooks on their armor, or running the hooks that are on their arms over the victim to rend flesh from bone.
I freeze dead right there, not even blink, to see if they've noticed me.
They have.
Run away! Okay.
And hopefully somebody's sixth sense will kick in because I've stop dead in my tracks.
Yes. So everyone, well, you guys don't have sixth sense, but you do.
I'm following. I see him.
Actually,
might even see the trauma that's coming up from there, and then you see these four figures.
Okay, I say to you guys before you even see them, say we're not alone. We've got trouble.
You two hear a squeak of panic.
I go running up the hill with my swords.
I'm going to switch places with.
Okay, so you're now seeing him running away from you up the hill.
Running to him.
No, he's no longer there. He's now there.
Oh, yes. Well, I kind of. Okay, I just keep running.
Right, so we are into full-on initiative. Give me a second here.
That's a neat trick.
For reference, I'm the perfect bodyguard. In fact, I can switch places with any of my team.
But you might think twice when swapping with the guy.
That ain't ever
gonna happen. No, it's not gonna happen.
Never gonna happen.
But I'll protect you, buddy. I got your back.
So I can just see him going, I'm in lots of danger. Where is the Kai?
I would obviously have crested the hill so that I've got a view. If I can just get a layout of how the four, are they literally coming from four different sides or?
Okay, I'll answer your question now.
Thank you.
I'm just bringing out these fellows here. Okay, so, sure, that's interesting.
Never a good sign.
Never a good sign.
GM says
yeah.
that. Oh, mm-hmm. I didn't read that first time.
Well, I did, but I didn't realize that they had a thing.
They have a common skill of what?
That's what I'm going
with. Oh, God.
They have how many attacks?
Just ours. It's just us grinding ourselves onto that armor.
Indeed.
Speak for yourself, old boy.
Unfortunately, although you teleport instantly, they were about to strike.
Oh no!
You may make the combat roll. So they pull, their process basically is they step forward, and as they're swinging, these long blades slide out from underneath their arms, and they're just basically punching into you. So there's four of them. Your combat skill is
25.
You
like not so squishy.
I'm squishy. I've just got weapons in front of me to protect me.
You have a plus four ratio. So the first one sort of steps in and just swings at you. You do a low duck and just slide your blade in between the plates of his mass of his armor. And there is an almost satisfying feeling of warm liquid spraying over your elbow and shoulder.
Except?
It's spraying over your shoulder.
Okay. No, as long as it's red and blood and not like eating away at me, then...
No. He's sort of, you get this guttural kind of growling sound coming out of him. It's a language you understand.
Mm. From my childhood.
Mm. All right.
There's more to me than you think, huh?
Indeed.
I thought you were weird.
Then another one attacks you.
Three. No, that's not good.
That's not good. You take seven.
Do you want to write on here? Here we go.
You take three. Sorry, apologies. You take three. This one comes around and tries to slide, basically do the same thing to you, but from the front area.
Yeah.
And you just sort of slide the weapon out and up and round,
yeah.
Sort of carving a U-shape in his breast plate, doing quite considerable damage.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I was using the blade to parry and move it, but it didn't quite... It's not just their blood on me anymore.
Then the third one steps forward, make your...
God.
Attack on
the knife. Look, he knows how to fight. He doesn't know how to fight.
If you hadn't been jealous before, I just walked through, teleport in front of him, slid through one,
cut the other,
blast off the other one, and stabbed the third.
The third, and then
the fourth one.
On your swing down, you realize he's coming up to you from the side. So you literally just flipped your blade around and drove up. And sits right underneath his chin and bursts out of his helmet. He stumbles dead right next to you with this blade stuck in him.
He knows his business.
The last one, yes, make your attack.
Seven.
I need to change your dice.
No.
Okay.
Frankie's not so good for fighting like in sparring, but...
It's that Kai influence.
Correct. You pull that blade down and you just bring your hand up on the
I'm
fighting
with two, so it's...
We are fighting with two, yeah. So then you just sort of bury that.
Stick him.
Correct. Yeah. Sort of in his side. It does quite a lot of damage, but at the same time he does swipe down and that clips you for one.
Just... Oh. Yeah.
sounds so
while I was standing him up, it's like the second one edges the blade off with the second blade.
Okay.
It's a world.
The only defense I have is the sword.
Wow. It's so not working for you right now.
It'll work for first attack.
Sword.
That'll do.
Oh, can I get there?
You can start running up the
Yeah,
the
I'm
hill.
Certainly
Absolutely.
Running. Yeah.
Yes, you can get there for towards sort of the end. You can just sort of sprint up. It's not a difficult path.
Okay. I come in with a loud, "I'm coming, buddy!" And I didn't do one of them. 4-7.
What's your combat score?
21.
21 at this point. You're going to go after that one, so that gives you a difference of 1. And you rolled a 7.
7.
Mm-hmm. You smash into him quite neatly.
Yes, I'm just barging him out the way.
He stumbles under the weight of your blow, but one of his hooks flails out and catches you for 1.
Oh, well, yeah, okay. Chainmail. That's what it's there for. Mm.
Gaetano?
Okay, so there's one remaining standing.
No, there's three.
So they're the
not
three
that good.
Engaged with Fierce Sword and
You're
two with Halo.
Okay, so the two on Halo, what state are the two in?
Bloodied.
Both bloodied.
You can see they've both taken wounds. There's a vile red blood sort of squirting between the bits of armor here and there.
Yeah. So they didn't gank me.
The one that is closest to him, the armor that they have around them, I look at it, I lift my hand up and I say, "Splitzin."
Oh, that's the German one.
And you'll have to help me with exactly how magic works in this, but using
3 willpower, mm-hmm. You'll need to do a DC save against that. And I'll add an extra willpower point into that. So I'll do 4 willpower on that.
All right, the armor literally shatters.
What do you hit him
correct.
With?
Correct.
What is the splinter?
Mm. Oh, he just...
So that 4 willpower you now deduct from your total. If your
That's
willpower
right.
achieves 0, you are unconscious.
Yeah.
And he took that as damage directly.
The armor literally just yeah. exploded. So what has happened is his defenses have now changed quite significantly.
Oh, but he didn't take damage.
Mm-hmm.
No. Unless it was forged to it. It's probably just
yeah.
the
yeah.
casing.
That brings us all the way around to Skrit.
Oh, Skrit!
I
you were sure you were standing in the camp, now you're standing down the pathway.
Yeah, I and then I see one of them fall because
yeah.
he did, and I squeak with a bit of glee and realize I am too far away to help. So I'm going to take this round, edging into, not running towards the combat, but around to a safe space where I might be able to use my sling. But super cautious because I've just seen what is up there, so it'd probably take me the whole round. Also checking nothing's coming from behind us. Twitch. 10.
He's on form.
I'm absolutely fine.
Super paranoid. Twitch.
You're watching and you realize that the camp is sort of here on the hill. So you've got the hill coming down here and the camp sort of halfway up.
Good.
Standing up quite a ways up is a figure dressed in very similar spiky armor. But he's got this massive red plume of horsehair or some other creature's hair on top of this helmet.
Okay.
And he appears to just be watching.
Okay. I squeal, Captain! Captain! That's all I get out. So I'm still trying to, like, yeah.
That's all you get out.
Twitch.
Right.
From where I am, I'll be able to look up and spot him.
You hear the sort of noise.
Squeak.
Yeah, you look up, you see this fella. He's obviously standing on a promontory of rock to be able to look down. He's probably about 300 or 400 yards away through quite dense forest. But he's literally just watching. That brings us back to the top of the round with my gentleman going first, which means Halo, would you please make a roll?
9.
Yep. Wow.
Those dice never roll those numbers for me.
No. Wow. In a fit of anger, he basically snarls. You understand what he's saying. And his snarl is "Die, Sumalandring." And he tries to power punch you from either side. All you do is you take one step back and then just step forward with your blade right underneath his helmet. And your blade slides all the way through and you feel the tip of it touching the back of his helmet. And then you pull it out quite neatly. And then watches the spray of blood sort of coats his chest plate as he crumbles
nice
to the floor. The other one bellows in rage, and he swings at you. Make your attack.
Stop that!
If you can't hit the table, you can't hit the creature.
6.
This is the one that doesn't have any armor on.
Yeah. I'm going to just flip behind him for whatever this is going to happen.
He swings wildly out at you. You just bring your sword. Well, you bring your sword straight down on the back of him because he doesn't have any armor on anyway. And it just cuts straight through his shoulder. It's grunting. He kind of falls to the floor, blood spraying everywhere. Then there's one against you.
3. Not so exciting.
You cut into him. He takes quite a bit of damage, but he lashes out with a mace and does 4 to you.
I'm all good.
It bounces off of your armor.
Yeah, I deflect it off myself, yeah.
Okie dokes.
It knocks me, but it's a deflection.
Not to your sword?
Not today.
You've gone Gaetano.
So there's still 3 left, actually.
2 left.
2 left.
One I'm facing.
And the captain. You say the captain is far. I mean, long range, I wouldn't be able to reach.
No.
Well, there's ways.
There are ways.
There's him running down the mountain. I'm coming. No, there's the captain bang in the middle of us.
Yeah.
I can't teleport. I can't switch places with him.
Any allies.
But I can jump me there and then switch with one of us.
Ah.
Yeah.
It would be draining, but
nah. Yeah, let him come to us, maybe.
Unless he unleashes fireballs.
What are you doing, Gitana?
I will look down and which is the most threatening of the remaining?
It's difficult to tell because Halo really is just the only thing that's threatening is the amount of time that it's taking him to move through these various people.
Yeah.
But none of them seem to be posing any threat to him.
Oh, shit.
Right, so what are you doing?
I think I feel fairly confident that the two fighters are handling the two down in the pit. But I definitely don't want the captain to escape. So I'm going to turn my attention to him up on the ridge. Mm. And I'm going to look in his direction, extend my arm and grip like this, which should apply the powers of the Desi to grasping him and holding him there.
Okay, does he get any, well, what is it?
So that is a combat or escape test.
Okay, let's do a combat check.
Of 9.
Oh, of 9?
Yeah.
Wow. He looks down at his arm, where you're grabbing him, and basically just shucks it off.
Right.
Looks nice. Down at you, then turns and starts walking down the stonework. You realize that once he's walked off his promontory of rock,
I won't be able to see him. Mm. Yeah.
Great.
I scurry up a boulder or a little bit of...
Plenty.
Give me a little bit of height. And I'm going to use my... Where was it? Sling.
Mm.
To try and do some damage to the armored beast.
The ones that are there busy.
There's only one left.
Yes.
Mm. You can't... Yeah, okay. Make your attack.
Awesome if I took him out.
Range attack.
Not likely to happen.
At a minus.
What's your combat skill?
8. I rolled a 4.
Sorry, I'm trying to work out.
Minus 11. I think was in the round.
So not so.
Is he going to damage himself
off the armor?
Well, no, you can't.
You swing the staff around and then realize that. The bottom half and the top half are moving in opposite directions. And then you have an eye patch as this thing wraps around your head and cups over your eye.
Ball, mate.
And then the rock goes.
Hey, at least I didn't lose the ammo, right?
This is true. You didn't.
Wow.
8.
At least he can't hit you from this range. So,
sure,
you
know. So there's no retaliation.
The last, there's two still standing. The last one attacks you.
Two still standing.
Yeah, there's one on you.
Where's
you didn't lose that one. What a pussy.
No, 10.
Yeah. That dice.
He dies horribly.
Yes.
Sorry, you were quite right. There's only one left, and he just
gurgled.
Sorry, I didn't look at my notes properly. Yeah, so there is a quiet that settles out.
I look at you like.
You were taking too long.
Can't I just kill one? Right, so yeah, can I see the leader on the
Climb back up and go cap. Climb back down next
way,
to
me.
What did we see? What's going on?
It was a captain up top. I tried to grasp him, but he got away.
Alright.
Fellow in black, big red mane.
I know what to do about this.
Where?
Up there. All right, let's get him.
See, there's a promontory of rock.
I'm gonna teleport up there.
I'm running.
What's your range?
Long.
Okay. Well, the rock is not so far. I don't know if that's as long as long, but fine. You find yourself
standing. They aren't exact ranges.
No, I know. You find yourself standing on this promontory of rock.
Ain't no way he's having fun without me. I'm running.
You're busy running through foliage and pushing aside stuff.
You hear shouting.
From the rock, you look down, and do you have tracking?
Nope.
Do you have survival?
Nope.
Do you have... No, I've run out of things to offer you.
No,
no hunting?
Now would be a good time maybe to swap someone who does.
If I could see somebody who could...
But I would be running up with them. What happened, I'm afraid there's an ambush on the other side.
Here's the thing. We were fighting over here. He was watching from over here.
So I went there.
Everybody else is running.
I'm running with everybody.
I'm going to see if I can spot one of the two of them.
You can hear me.
Six.
Six is more than sufficient. You can see him and you can't see him.
Switch places.
You run down the rock a little bit.
I'm using willpower like a demon, but
I kind of come to a stop. Like, what the heck just happened? Where am I? And what's going on? Have a look around.
You look around and you realize that whoever was standing watching had been there for quite some time.
Yeah.
Had possibly anticipated your arrival, but upon their departure, they had simply got up, walked down the rock, mounted some kind of beast. That has a fairly large paw print that looks like a wolf's print, and then had ridden off in the direction of the castle.
Okay, well, when you run up and catch up to me,
this beast was moving quickly.
Yeah, okay, well,
I'm walking back to the camp where we got ambushed, and then I'm going to start searching what they were doing there.
Okay, what are you doing, Major the Desai?
Well, I'm still in the camp over there. Until I've got word of what's going on, I'll also look around. So I'll do some investigation around the camp.
Roll.
Now that they swapped and he's turned around and gone back, can I see him?
I'm looking for Prince.
Yeah.
Okay, so I run him because he's not in combat. So okay.
Six.
Ten.
All right, between the two of you, you're looking around the camp and you realize that... the Kai had definitely been here because squelched and gummed up into the mud, you find the very distinctive silver brooch with the wolf's head symbol carved into it. That's been tracked into the mud. You suspect that may be the pin from
Kindheart's
cloak.
Well, I'm going to pick it up and...
There is also a lock of blonde hair that has been caught on some low branches. It's a few tufts of blonde hair. None of these things seem to have had any kind of hair, let alone blonde hair.
Speaking of that, I'm going to go pull a helmet off and, well, the guy's armor shattered. What the is this thing?
So you realize that these are Drakkarim. They are the elite foot soldiers of the armies of the Dark Forces. Very large, very, very heavy set humans. The very ancient ancestors of the Summerland folk. But just heavy set, heavily scarred, tough lives, broken noses. This is someone that has grown up in a very violent society. All of them are similar.
Okay.
You find, while sort of looking amongst the... You realize that there are some lean-tos that collapsed long ago. You sort of lift up one or two. You lift up one, and this very, very disgruntled badger looks up and then disappears off into the foliage.
Doesn't have a gun.
No. And it's where it had been, you can see someone has dropped a piece of a doll, a little wicker... made doll. There was some fabric used to give it some color, but that's unusual for what else is around, which is scrapped bones of a meal.
I'll sort
of
thing. Pick that up to take a look at it.
Kai brooch.
A lock of a Kai brooch and a lock of golden blonde hair.
The two of you have...
I've just found the footprints and he comes up to me, joins me by the stage, so I show him the footprints, tell him it's a beast. And then I head back to them. So we go jog back down to where they are.
I grab hold of his pants. Not yet.
Okay, what?
Because I don't want to be left alone.
What is it?
Do I recognize the smell of the beast or also to maybe track the captain next time? Any distinguishing smells or scents?
It's a bit tricky because he got here first, so his scent is all around.
True.
And it's a good scent.
There is that harsh, harsh smell of fat and oil again that permeates. There is then also a very, very wet dog aroma.
I can't tell. I was hunting. I went tracking. I wouldn't have learned about this beast.
If this was something natural, it would be a wolf that would stand about 6 or 7 foot of the shoulder.
That sounds like fun.
So we've probably done this before. So I go. I start to list the things, the breakdown of what I can smell. Does he recognize it?
Probably. You also pick up scent of fish. Quite strongly.
Since I can't find with my 10, 11, whatever, when I was searching, if I can't find anything more, I'm going to sit down and meditate while these two take their time.
I come back to camp then, because I assume there's nothing more once we
let him go.
Look at that. I walk back to camp and I come and kneel down at the bodies of the dead and take all their helmets off. Just it's a macabre thing to see if I recognize any of their faces from my childhood.
Meditate.
You recognize the same patterns from your childhood. Broken noses, scarred, torn lips, piercings, heavy tattooing, just over the brutal, savage people that they were. Reminds you of your mother.
Yes.
Yes, indeed. I've also been meditating after the
search. You're meditating, right. Mm. So you can meditate for an hour to regain hit points and...
How many hit
willpower?
Points?
It's one hit point and one willpower per 10 minutes. Unless you have Kai healing or some other healing power, which I don't think we brought with us today.
There would be nothing of worth on their bodies, I'm guessing.
You go through them. They've all got that plate mail armor, but it's designed for a very big, bulky person. Wouldn't fit you. Otherwise...
Look at these muscles.
It looks as if they were here... maybe for a day or two.
Yeah.
And so one of them's got a rather crude sack that's on his back. And inside there's some rather mangy looking survival biscuits, flint and tinder, that sort of thing. Otherwise they looked as if they had been told, suit up, we're going on a short sortie. You'll be back tomorrow.
It doesn't look like they came from far. They weren't equipped for a long journey.
Well, I think they're from the castle, and it's not far to the castle.
To the castle? Tomorrow? Today?
I think we should at least be approaching the castle, but to do so carefully. We did notice the village before the castle. How far is it to the village?
About the same distance. The village is built up around the castle walls.
What's the time at the moment?
About 10:30 in the morning.
Oh, we've got the day.
Up we go.
So you get back onto the tracked road and you start making your way
following the footprints.
The wolf footprints do not go anywhere near the track.
Just for reference, we meditate for an hour. So if anybody else needs rest, did you take any damage?
No.
It is now lunchtime.
Wolf footprints, village.
Wolf tracks head off in the direction of the village.
Oh.
But what I'm saying is you've got wolf tracks on the side of the mountain, and then you've got the cart road that runs along the coast.
Should we follow the wolf tracks and see if we can find this guy?
If they're going to the same place.
They are.
Why take the difficult route?
Because we might find the guy and the wolf.
Right.
I myself prefer the cart track.
it's safer. There's giant wolves.
What if I took the high track and shattered you guys in the mountainside? Because I'll be able to see you from up there.
I like this idea.
After all, I have my Kai. No, I don't have any Kai disguises. That's not true. But I could still try.
Him not being around is like...
And if we run into any difficulty where we need to throw you in first?
Oh, fine. I'll stay with the party.
Thank you. That's very kind.
Okay, we make our way along the goat track thing.
Cart track. The cart track winds.
You can scout.
Yes, I will scout.
And that means we're downwind of it.
Yeah, I think about seeing anything slightly ahead.
Okay.
And I sniff the track. The trail.
This track hasn't been used in quite some time.
Okay.
Well, before he heads
off in front of you, and then obviously you're just picking up his smell.
Yeah, well, I try to get
there. Were no smells of, well, I suppose it's been 2 weeks since the last kayak entry, so.
The track winds its way along this rather steep cliff, which affords a magnificent view over Tuz Bay, which stretches out in almost all directions from this particular point on the cliffside. It is an easy 150-foot, 200-foot drop down to the waters below. But the track itself is about 10 feet or 20 foot from the edge, so it doesn't cause too much concern. At about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so 3 hours of trudging along, you have seen nothing, no signs of anything.
So this hasn't been used for a while, this track?
No, and the grass has already started to grow up around it. Mm. You break out of the forest that's skirting the edge of the cliff, and you can see signs of civilization.
So there's movement or just signs of civilization?
The village and the castle is probably a mile away by now, and then surrounding it are these rather poor farmlands. Crops that are not growing very well, fields that have not been very well maintained.
Is there life though? I mean, is there, you know, smoke and from chimneys?
Yes, from the villages, yeah, and the castle has got banners fluttering
in
the breeze.
So there is life.
Correct,
yeah,
yes, okay. Very much so. As a matter of fact, you can see peasants and things working in the fields very slowly, and they look very malnourished, but they are working.
I wait for them to catch up to me at the edge of the forest.
I carry on sniffing the...
you get your senses are assailed with human excrement, rotting vegetation, starvation, disease.
The smell of a village in the morning.
The same basically. Smell of fish?
There is a very strong smell of fish, yes. And you can see why. At one point, the cliffs have lowered themselves all the way down to form a sort of a white sandy beach. And there are boats, quite a few of them, pulled up, and large amounts of fish hanging, drying in the sun.
Okay. Worth questioning a peasant or two?
Well, it's certainly worth going up to the village and finding out about people who wear red feathers in their hair.
I'll follow your lead.
Right. We'll follow on through into the village.
Okay. Every peasant that you pass takes one look at you, turns, and heads very purposefully in the opposite direction. They're not good at hiding their attempts to avoid you.
Is it animosity, fear? What am I sensing?
Fear, mainly. There is a definite fear about them that they're heading, causing them to head away. You get into the village proper itself, and by village proper I mean there's a large muddy track that leads up to a very imposing gatehouse directly in front of the main keep itself. Branching off of that are little huts and things that are...
I'm keeping a specific lookout. I know it's difficult with heavy usage and stuff, but I'm just looking for traces of footprints of a larger wolf nature that might be in a puddle of mud or something.
Certainly can't see any sign of it here. And as the village is built, the promontory of cliff stretches out into the ocean, and the village is right on that, and then the castle sits behind it, literally out in the middle of the ocean. So if there was anything approaching, it would have to either be weaving through the back streets, or if it took the main road, the tracks have been destroyed or simply not there.
We'll aim for a town hall or some sort of central building.
There doesn't look to be any kind of central area. The market is probably the best option. And to call it a market was very generous. It's really just a square of sodden earth with old straw meshed into it. And a few stands with two very miserable looking old women sitting behind them. One is selling fish and the other one is selling what looks to be clothing. Although you're not entirely sure if the mud is an added feature or if it's just part of the style.
We'll approach them, seeing as it's the only people that haven't managed to scuttle away.
Well, the one does. She sees you coming and she literally pulls down the sort
front of her
wicked roof,
yes,
and disappears. The other one sort of looks frantically around and realizes that her wares are spread out too much for her just to leave.
Yes.
And so she sits, she...
I'm guessing it's the fish.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid, ma'am.
we've just come along to find out what might have happened to some friends of ours.
He's still
came
got
this
blood
way.
Splattered all over him and stuff. But I mean, okay, yeah, Karen.
No, it was just a shoulder. Everything else was...
He's standing behind, at least with my finery, I'm standing in front.
Her eyes remain downcast and she doesn't say anything.
We had three Kai brethren who followed this way a little while ago, about 2 weeks back, and we're just looking for them. Would you have seen them at all?
No.
Are you sure?
I step next to him. Perhaps we could make it worth your while if you give us just a little bit of information, a tip. I'm using influence. If you were to assist us, we would move along very quickly and
very
be out of your hair and you could get on with whatever you're doing and have a better day.
Make an influence check.
It's so cute.
Yeah, charming mouse.
He is a charming mouse.
Do I add anything
mouse.
To it?
Yeah, minus one.
And anything else you might
why need? Minus one?
Because his
stats
are
so low.
Mm-hmm. But you have the skill influence,
which gives
you
a plus one. Anything
so
else?
Assist on four.
Can anybody assist on that?
I assist with a coin.
Well, that's okay. Before you bring out the coin, she looks up and she says, "I don't know anything. Go away, please."
And then
I
bring out the coin and make sure that light hits the coin.
No,
it hits in the eye.
Just
first.
Sorry,
first little scruffy one.
Take
let's
a look around,
see if
there's see if anyone's actually watching.
Let's see if
no,
there's somewhere private we could...
Apart from people on the battlements.
Yeah. Let's see if there's...
Oh, the, you can actually...
I don't know anything. Go away.
I'm going to stand in front of the... Just like... So, blocking any kind of view onto her. Just to maybe like show that we're... Making sure she can't be talked to.
Mm-hmm.
We're just and just, and fish, and just like... I'm going to be like just looking... Trying to like... hide anything happening behind me.
Perhaps you'd be more comfortable if we took this conversation indoors.
I said go away. Gods, help! Help! Help!
Now look
go
at
away.
What you've done.
Help!
leave.
Everyone's like, where's Skrit?
If there's a barrel or something, I make sure
I'm
there.
Well,
walk away.
Yes, we move away. It might just be me, but maybe we should leave negotiations to the Kai in future.
All right, so where to now? The gates?
Well, is it, are any
before
guards
the
reacting?
The gates are currently opening.
Mm. With her having guards.
What?
Oh dear. Right, who's coming out of those gates? Because we're now kind of walking up in that direction.
There appears to be six fairly well-armed men in rather heavy leather tunics, all emblazoned with Lord Cragan's symbol, which is a serpent wrapped around a staff.
So these are Sunderland people, part of the...
I will say to the woman, but quietly once again, using my wonderful language of Desi, I shall say to her, quietly but kindly, we are here on business of the Kai Lords.
Look! Just fuck off! Leave me alone! She says.
Okay.
I didn't say anything, she screams. I didn't say anything!
She didn't say anything.
Why don't you be the negotiator in this team?
But let's the guards are coming this way, right?
The guards are walking straight towards you. They haven't seen you, but they've seen the other you three.
Yeah, I will stand there and wait for them.
Do any of them smell a wet dog?
If you want to disappear,
fish,
you
fish
can.
Just overpowers everyone.
And I'll have a conversation with them, and if the conversation goes wrong, I just get the fuck out of there.
Okay,
So, they're heading down from the keep.
Yeah. Straight towards you. They've seen the three of you.
Okay, is there a doorway I can step into?
There's a wattle and daub sort of entrance way.
Because that's not suspicious.
I'd like to step into that so that I'm at least a little bit...
Like an inch.
Hidden.
I'm causing the distraction by standing there waiting for them.
I'm waiting for them too. We're just watching them walking.
I'm waiting for them, waiting for them.
We're all waiting for them.
Hopefully you've disappeared. The whole point of
he's hiding
the fact that I can teleport the fuck away at any point. Therefore, if everybody else ran for it, I could still have the conversation and disappear.
It can still go bad and you can still survive.
Yeah.
I'm watching everybody disappearing. I'm like,
okay,
so they stop in front of it.
What is the problem here?
Well, they're not there.
Oh no, they've seen him stepping into the doorway.
Oh, bollocks.
As I said, not suspicious.
We're here investigating the disappearance of three Kai Lords.
And you are entitled to disrupt the peacefulness of this village, are you?
Forgive me, it's my companions. They're accompanying me on this mission, and they lack a bit of tact.
Then you will all accompany me. Thank you very much. Back to our lord.
As you insist, very well.
The
Gaetano, they wanting us to go with them. You can come out now. Leave the fisherwoman alone.
I step out of the building, but I'm muttering. I'm going.
All right, it's just the three of us, so let's go.
Subtle as an oyster.
Take me to your lord.
You will come with us. They form a square around you three. And one of them grabs the old woman. And she's like, no, I didn't say anything. He hits her with a backhand. You're coming with us. And well, then you...
She has got a filthy tongue on her.
Really? Really?
She has nothing to do with this.
Our lord will judge that. Let's go.
All right, we go with
and
them.
And you get marched off.
The three of us.
Did none of them go for a mouse?
No, they didn't see the mouse.
There are the walls, do they look wide enough for people to be walking along them?
Oh yeah, you can see people walking along them.
Okay, I'm going to time it so that, because they'll walk through and whatever, and the guards, I'm assuming, will carry on their patrols.
Mm-hmm.
So I have the agility, I think it's the agility, rodent's agility, where I can... the description is run up walls as easily as I walk on horizontal ground.
Right.
That's great. And I haven't hoarded enough yet to not be able to do that. So time it, wait for them to go through, scurry up the wall, watch to see where they go, scurry back down.
On the other side.
Weave my way through. I want to see if they're being taken to lock up, if they're being taken to a main hall, and just shadow them. Using okay. also my rat reflexes and my speedy twitchiness.
All right.
Because you could scurry like almost on the ceiling.
You are taken through the main
gatekeep.
And you are led into a fairly large quad. And you can see there's a line of statues that runs in front of the main castle itself. And then a very large quad that you now find yourselves in. They take you to the very center of the quad, so you are easily 60 feet from any wall or door.
With all the arches around us.
Well, there are four guards on the walls patrolling, and then there's another two guards in each of the towers, of which there are four. Then there inside you can see there's a stablery. You can't see inside of that because it's walled, wooden walls. There appears to be a blacksmith of some kind. You can hear noise, the tang tang coming from inside it. And of course then the very large imposing keep. You scurry up the wall. Make a stealth check, please.
I get plus one. Two.
The guard is busy doing his round. And walks right past you, and you're kind of frozen on top of the battlements. And the guard walks past you, like, you didn't see me?
Like a ninja.
Drunken ninja.
Drunken ninja. You look down and you see them in the quad. Now you see that the guard who walked past you, you see he's got about another 100 foot down.
Sure.
And then he turns, and then he's going to come back.
Is there a lip on the inside of the window? I can just sit through and stand up.
There's the battlements, then there's the walkway next to it. And the walkway is actually just an open, flat top. It's the top of the wall, really.
Okay.
And then it drops down into the quad below.
I guess there's no ridge thing.
Not really. You could run to one of the towers. I have a map. I actually drew this castle. It actually exists.
Yeah, can I... If I could scurry up higher, would there be a point looking from there?
Do you want to look at the map?
At the best...
It doesn't have how the roof is.
No, but it's a wall. So at best, you can climb up onto the actual tower. sure. itself, and that will get you right to the top.
Sure, I can do that.
All right. Okay, so you're going
to
be.
Can I use my sixth sense to just sort of out of the corner of my eyes see him? Because I would be trying to be aware of where he might be. He is my companion.
He is, but sixth sense won't help you with that so much. You know that he's near.
Okay.
You don't know where exactly he is. Your sixth sense, though, is being overrun by a very dark presence in this castle.
Mm.
It is very, very, very negative. They lead you to the center of the quad. Wait here. And the woman falls to her knees sobbing. And the guards then walk back to the gatekeeper.
We wait here, looking at... I'm just taking into account all the possible escape routes and guard positions as best I can.
Well, there are four main towers which overlook this quad, and then three smaller ones that look down as well. Each of the towers has got one guard in it, but their focus doesn't seem to be so much inward as outward. There is a set of stairs that runs up to the main keep itself. So the entrance to the keep is actually on the second floor, not on the on the first floor, not on the ground floor. There's the stablery, there's the blacksmiths, there's some other bits and pieces, but otherwise the only other exit seems to be off the cliff into the ocean below. There's one side of the castle doesn't have a wall; it's just this panoramic view out over into Tuz Bay.
Very pretty. May I use my knowledge in the occult to have a sense of what this dark sort of foreboding is?
Well, you don't see. You don't have success.
I turn around. Since we're alone in the courtyard, I turn around to you and I say, "There's a very strong presence of evil here. I sense it, overwhelmingly.
Yeah,
it's heavy.
I would like to perceive what I could perceive. Just basically look, take a look. If there's anything else that we might have missed on the first street glance.
There does appear to be a rather. Well, the well, which is separate from the keep, the well normally has several buckets around it, and you can see evidence of water being splashed normally.
Mm.
This is very, very dry. It hasn't been used in quite some time. Mm. Other than that, it just looks like a fairly sparsely maintained castle, but then again, there are no known enemies in this region, so it kind of makes sense. You also realize that the guards in the four towers are very still. You get to the top of the one tower and make a perception check.
8.
As you're about to pop over the balustrade, you realize that the guard is standing almost next to you. So you kind of freeze.
I hold in the squeak.
And then you realize that there's no sound, and there's just the strong aroma of rotting flesh.
Slowly.
Since I was seeing that, can I spot that one, just in case?
No, your perception was high enough. Yes, you see him going up the side of the tower. As you raise yourself up, you look into the cadaverous face of a human once, but the face has long since rotted off, and a rather large spike has been shafted up the body to keep it standing in place. It's just blankly staring out.
Look back at the one that's doing the patrols. He looks pretty alive still, doesn't he?
Correct.
He smells pretty alive.
Correct. From this vantage point, you can now see that all of the towers have got these skewered guards with their hollow eyes that no longer see. And then there are literally just four guards patrolling the perimeter.
Has the figure been skewered, as in the armor is pierced, or is it just been...
sort of scurry over the edge so you can do a full investigation.
See if there's any shiny I can...
Just waiting for the...
Yeah. Most of this is rusted. This is easily 2 or 3 or 4 months old.
Sure, okay.
And it looks as if the individual, now you realize what happened. His hands were tied behind his back, and then he was skewered onto a rather nasty metal rod, which has basically been jammed into the floor, but he was on it when it was being jammed into the floor. And then the spear has sort of been stabbed through his arm to keep it upright.
Okay. There is a way down off here, like a ladder.
Yes,
or
so if you look around, you see there's a trap door in the top of the tower, which is closed, but you would imagine would take you all the way down.
Okay.
Well, so that's ominous. We are waiting.
Occult actually gives me the ability, it's like detect
is
magic.
It?
So,
okay,
yes, so I can actually detect.
Yes.
Hmm.
You. Sense sort of stretching out your feelings and looking that this is all an affront. This is all just a front. The guards that are walking up and down are all under a trance. They're literally walking, stopping, turning, and walking. There is no thought in their movement, and there's also no disinterest or laziness. They are under some kind of control.
Yeah,
programmed.
But the ones that brought us inward, they looked normal.
They look normal.
Yeah.
They have by now left through the gates.
Yeah.
Mm. The doors to the keep open, and a rather thin-looking person stands at the very top. He is dressed in purple robes that sort of flow quite freely. And he comes gliding down the stairs. His hands are particularly white and quite long. And you can see that his nails seem to be rather longer than usual.
Do I sense evil in him?
Yes. Yes, you do.
Really? You needed a sixth sense.
Just waiting for it to go down. Welcome to my castle.
Long white flowing hair and a rather neat Fu Manchu style moustache.
Kill him now or later.
He comes gliding down the stairs. He passes the statues. As he passes the one statue, his hand comes out and he just rubs the foot ever so delicately, almost lovingly. It's the foot of this rather large statue of... You think it's a big warrior dressed in plate mail with a shield, but bits of it have sort of crumbled and fallen off.
Okay.
Fairly old, but...
Yeah.
Yes.
Not like something that's turned to stone and it could be turned into something else quickly.
That's yeah. No, this was more of a fond memory. This is a reassuring...
Embrace.
Okay.
Embrace, yes. He comes gliding to a stop in front of you.
No, you looked like you wanted to say something else.
No, sorry, this is me. I'm looking at you for, like, should we kill him now or later? Because that's what you asked.
Right.
I look at you, and then I look back at him, and I say...
I know that's not a good idea, but I'm here to protect you, so...
We are here to meet your lord. I'm from the Kai Monastery. We're investigating the disappearance of three previous Kai initiates.
Ah!
Yes, that's what I said. Should I say it again?
That is greatly unfortunate that three lords should go missing. I wonder where they went.
That is why I'm here, to find out.
Unfortunately, my lord is detained at the moment. So I'm afraid your endeavour will have to take a turn.
We know of Lord Cragen. Who might you be?
I am his humble servant. I am Steward Krelok.
I'm just looking at the warlock here, like, do I do something? What do I say? What do I do? Like, give me that.
I understand you would have taken a considerable journey to reach us in our humble abode here. And so the lady of the castle wishes you to entertain with her this evening and to rest. And then tomorrow be on your journey back.
We will accept her hospitality.
I am so pleased. I will convey it to her, and I assure you she too will be pleased. If you would wait here just a moment longer, I will instruct the cook to bring something out as nourishment. It is merely a formality, you understand.
Good, thank you.
Thank you.
He turns and glides back up the stairs and back into the castle and closes the door.
Ideas. I would particularly be using some occult skill on himself, but gliding away to sense what I can sense of him.
Any descriptions of the long white hands? And that
no, but there's, you know,
so much more.
So the robe that he's wearing is remarkably valuable. The reason why it looks like he's gliding is because this would be called, in the Desi circles, possibly a robe of sustenance. But not just sustenance as in you wear it and you don't need to eat. It is sustenance as in you wear it and it will keep you alive.
So you don't age, or you slow your age and such.
Depending on how powerful the robe was, you might not ever age. Or you might simply age at a much, much, much slower rate.
Is that not evil in some kind of
way? It is evil. It is definitely evil.
Okay.
He did have two rings on his fingers, which you noticed as well with your arcane searching. And the one ring is, it has on it a strange symbol. It looks like it is a alligator or a crocodile or a large lizard. You're not entirely sure exactly what it was supposed to be. But that is the one. And then the other, which was worn on the other hand, was simply a rather large red garnet inset into a gold band. You almost sensed its presence from where you were. Almost.
My curiosity has gotten the better of me yet again. I want to open the trapdoor.
There's a ladder going down to the second floor. There is an ungodly stench of rotting flesh wafting up towards you.
You and that sensitive nose of yours.
Yeah, wow.
If I have any little tears, I can't cover it up. I need to know if it changes. So I slowly lower myself down.
Gagging.
Yeah.
You have dark vision?
No. No, not I changed. I swapped it out.
It's pitch black in here. There's no light.
Can I smell a lamp?
Only thing you can smell is this rotting, decaying flesh.
It is scary in there.
I keep my senses on edge and I lower myself down. I want to...
Have you never watched a horror movie? Don't go alone!
This thing waiting for me, its mouth open. No, yes, my curiosity, I will...
Okay, you climb down.
Feed it out.
Your foot... You don't wear boots.
No, that's how I can climb up. Yeah.
Your foot touches ground.
Sure.
And then as you're about to put your second foot down, your first foot sinks into the ground.
I lift it up and
dull
place
sort
it.
Of crackling sound. And then a wet feeling.
As you lift
your back foot out, it comes away, but so does other stuff which sort of drips
and
off of it.
Shake the foot.
Get out of there.
There's
that's
a
crap.
Splatting sound as stuff sort of slides off of your foot. The stench of decay trebles.
Yeah. You should get it.
And
there's no crack
in
the door. I can see where there's light or anything.
The trapdoor above you closes.
Okay. Can I see the outline of the trapdoor?
No, but where the very edge of the trapdoor is, you can see that there's something in between you and that trapdoor.
Okay, so we are waiting. No, he's in the pit. That's right.
No, well, no. This is where everything's happening right there.
So I freeze like I normally do.
Yes.
And I feel a squeak, breathing out my nose, or both.
What is happening?
You have that like irritating nasal sound. Is it moving?
You hear.
But is it moving? I don't care. So it's breathing. It's a good thing.
It starts moving towards you, yes.
Is my sixth sense picking up any immediate issue for my...
Not from the tower.
If it was... You can sense badness.
There's just
badness.
There's
just like
badness
whoomp,
everywhere.
Yeah. Whoomp.
There's a little speak over there, but it's like whoomp.
If I was to assume this size and shape of this room?
And where be the same as the tower.
Door would be?
The door would probably be down, back to the floor, and
I'm
on your left or on your right, but
that
you're
far off the ground.
Yeah, but you're in the top third of the tower, so there might not be a door off of here. There might be a trap door that goes down again.
Through the ick. Mm. And there's no side windows or, you know, arrows.
There are, but they're big. That wide. That wide.
Is light coming in?
No, not from them. They've been boarded up long ago. Like I said, there was no light. What is your combat skill, please?
What combat skill?
8. It's about to increase by 5 because I have fur frenzy. And I'm just about to freak out.
But now would be
a good time
a
to freak the fuck
great
out.
Time.
Freak out.
To freak out.
Freak out.
So you're in the dark, something's breathing, you freak out.
Is the
freak out?
Is the ladder
pawning.
Against
the
wall or
pawning.
Hanging?
That's where they go.
Hanging. I'm going to assume the creature is...
You could climb over the creature and get out the trapdoor above it if you're freaking out.
Yes. So I wait for the creature to get close to me.
Okay, it attacks.
Oh, okay.
Freak out ensues.
I'm going to...
Roll your combat. You get to roll.
Oh, do I get to roll?
Yeah, because remember, there's only us versus them.
So it's 8 plus 5, what, it's 13?
No.
Okay.
Just roll.
You want to know
you
what the...
You want to roll zeros and nines.
Zeros.
There we go. Wow. It slices at you and you realize that what this thing is it appears to be some kind of serpent that's coiled itself around this room.
Okay.
And what lashes out at you are these long, wet tendrils that... The first attack kind of, you think, lick you to get a sense of what you are.
You have to get out of this place.
In
sure.
Your terror, though, you claw back at it.
Sure.
And
get away. You
feel a liquid oozing out of it, and it kind of recoils a little bit, but it's ready to strike again. What are you doing?
So... I'm assuming that it's wrapped around somewhere and it's actually leaning away from the ladder, right? So I'm going to... what I was going to do is jump away, climb up the wall, and then leap at the...
Trapdoor.
But if it's not actually wrapped around the ladder coming down, then I can scurry up the ladder. So
sure.
That's what I'm going to do. Scurry up the ladder.
Okay, you scurry up the ladder.
Quadruple speed.
You
come
fling
flying
at
like,
it does get to attack you again. Make a roll.
Sure. I shouldn't roll this dice again. You know that, right?
Says the person just throw away 9.
What did you get?
2. But I'm going to I'm going to use my evasion as it's one of the things I got and lose a willpower to avoid damage this round.
It's a good thing.
Sure.
It's a good thing.
Probably would have swallowed
how much willpower do you lose?
1 every time.
And that's it.
Yeah, but
wow.
You remember, he can't hurt anything for shit.
Every time I do that, though, I land up with a scar. So I escape it by the skin of my teeth
or the tip of his tail.
I already have pieces of my ears missing and stuff because of that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's just like a rocket shoots out of the tower.
Minus a piece of tail.
Yes.
So
your tail is just that much shorter. These things wrap around your tail and you just launch out.
Yeah, rip a piece
of it, yes.
Does the trap door shut behind me or I want to see if it comes out so I can see what it is.
Crazy stuff in this place.
It does not.
Okay.
It doesn't like
do you slam
coming
the trap
out
door?
Of the dark.
Yes.
More importantly,
slam.
Does anybody else notice the
the mouse?
the amount of commotion happening in the tower.
You guys, yes, you do see this.
We don't have much else that we're looking
scurrying
at.
It's not
on.
Us I'm worried about.
The guards don't seem to have changed their rotatory movement.
I'm concerned about my mouse looking up. I'm like,
I think I've decided that being here is not a good thing to do. So I carefully scurry, making my way like level to level down, scamper towards them. I also see my foot. Is it ick like?
It's covered in, it's a combination color of sort of a purpley black tone. And then there is vast amounts of this brownish yellowish fluid, which is seeped into your fur.
Does it smell like digestive fluids? And
no, that would have been a benefit. No, this smells like...
Wow. Excrement.
Excrement mixed with...
Death.
Yeah, I stop by them and I like start to
you run,
scrape it off my foot.
If he's coming towards us, I'm going like...
I stop.
The door to the keep opens.
I see anything I can duck behind.
Sure, giant statue.
I scurry behind the giant statue.
Okay.
Okay, I'll just wait here. What does it smell like, the thing that's coming towards us?
The thing that's coming towards you, this, the aroma is without a shadow of a doubt. It has this very strong smell of chemicals.
Mm. Like embalming fluid.
Yeah, a very clean kind of smell. The exact opposite to the tower and that kind of thing.
Yeah. Mm. I'm still trying to get rid of all the ick on my foot.
He comes gliding down.
Fighting every
runs
instant.
His hand over your foot as he moves past the statue. Doesn't notice.
I've got my poor.
When he touched you, it felt colder than the stone that you're hiding behind.
Wow.
He's a dead body. What do you expect?
What do you expect from a corpse?
The great lady Tanley of the house is willing to see you now. Chef is preparing one of her favorite dishes just for you. If you would follow me, please.
Fantastic.
Very good.
I make sure I'm out of their view when he turns around. Stay there.
It's fighting every instinct not to kill him.
I know, I feel the same.
He turns, glides back up the stairs.
When he passes, I stand there and I do every symbol I know as like, not good, don't go.
You know, you could say it to him because there's nobody listening at the moment.
No, the guy's going upstairs.
Guy's just in front of you.
Okay. He's in front of us, so we're walking towards this one, and I'm just like...
I like... give up sort of thing, find it nearest...
You're like... the mouse is like...
I find a pillar and scurry up. So okay. Maybe I can follow them on the roof.
I have a person. They're going to enter in on the second floor.
Okay.
So the roof is three stories above that, so... You wouldn't be able to.
Are there ledges or something?
Yeah, you can get up to the roof without a problem. But
no
once
windows.
They enter the door. On the third and fourth and fifth floors, there are large, fairly ornate Gothic windows. Yes.
Can I slip into the. Well, first listen.
Okay.
Wait, don't slow everything down.
Slow down. All right, so you're going to go towards one of the windows.
Sure.
The three of you enter into this very small, 10 foot by 10 foot little room. Wooden paneling. There's some banners and banting that sort of has been strung up. And he takes you directly from that into this large hall, 100 foot long, 50 foot wide, great big pillars reaching up three stories directly up to this very large, very ornate stained glass window in the roof, which lets in this amazing kaleidoscope of colors. Into the hallway.
And hopefully a little shadow.
Sitting on a sitting on a throne on a dais at the very far end of the hall, which also has a great big rose window behind it, which looks out over the bay, is a rather delicate looking female. Woman, maybe in her mid-50s or so, wearing a rather flattering, it looks to be almost a scale male silver dress. And as you arrive, Krelok bows very low before her.
Fine.
Your guests have arrived, madam. Shall I call in the chef and her special dish? She waves him away. Very good, madam. He bows, turns to you three, bows, glides off out of a door on the side of the hall.
I bow. Good afternoon. My lady, I am from the Kai Monastery. We are hoping you'll be able to help us with information about three initiates that went missing 2 odd weeks ago. They were apparently in this area, and we were hoping perhaps you know something and could inform us on where to investigate or take this further.
I am aware of your three Kai. They came here, as a matter of fact.
Yes, very good. And what happened?
Nothing.
Yes.
They spent the evening. We had a delightful conversation about your order and your monastery. And then they informed me that they were heading further west to investigate some matters that they had come across there.
Success?
It's still thrumping.
Everywhere.
Everywhere is danger.
Okay, so, wonderful. May I inquire of your husband and his whereabouts?
Lord Cragen is currently occupied with other affairs elsewhere in the castle.
Oh, that's unfortunate. I was hoping to speak to him.
Why?
Well, I have been instructed to by my masters to see him. Thus, I would like to fulfill my mandate as best I can. But if you inform me that's not possible, then that is good enough reason.
He may join us for dinner later.
Very good. Very good. Did my colleagues show any sign or indication of where they were going and why they were going from here?
Unfortunately, they were very quiet when they got here, and they didn't say much. So no, they simply said that they had found something further to the west and that they were going to investigate it.
I see.
Could I use insight to work out if there's any logical flaw in the whole set of...
You can make a roll.
Mm-hmm.
Or a perception of if she's lying, or...
Four.
The Derncrag Mountains are to the west, and one does not simply
go
cross
to the, west.
The Derncrag Mountains.
Mountains.
You have to go through one of the passes, and the nearest pass is about 100 miles to the south.
Mm.
So to try and do it on your own would be very foolish, but perhaps they might have been going just into the foothills of the mountain, maybe?
Yeah, I don't need to know that she's lying to know that she's lying.
Mm.
Do you have any questions for the lady, my lady?
I don't think we're going to find out about our brethren any more here.
Yes, I agree.
I can have Krelok show you to the room that they stayed in. That might provide some insight as to their actions.
Would be helpful. It might give us a clue as to why they went to the west.
Yes.
Dum, dum, dum.
Yes.
We've had very little interaction with anything from the west, thankfully. Kai watches over us.
Yes, he does. I say, making the Kai symbol, which is what you should do if you mention Kai. Very well. Thank you, my lady. Your help has been very kind.
You scamper up to one of the stained glass windows.
Mm.
Well, one of the large Gothic windows.
Look,
you look inside and you can see there's a rather large fairly old-looking human male dressed in quite fine livery, and he appears to be debating quite heavily with another warrior, although this one is dressed in that same hook and spike plate mail. And under his arm he holds a helmet with a big red plume. They seem to be chatting casually. The rest of the room appears to contain nothing much, just a rather large table that's set at a 45 degree angle, and there is a rather naked looking human on the table, except the human appears not to have any of their bowels, as they've been removed.
I sniff. Firstly, obviously the guy with the plume smells like wet dog.
Uh-huh.
Any distinguishing features of the older man?
It's difficult to tell. The wet dog smell is quite strong. The man, you can't really pick up any scent on, but there is definitely a vague scent of Kai here.
For one quick thing, what happened to the old woman that was with us?
She remained in the quad.
Okay.
If I listen closely, can I make out certain words that might jump out in the conversation?
Make a stealth check.
Green dice are good.
Seven.
Seven is very good. You press your ear against the glass, which is cold in this afternoon sunlight, but you can hear. The one appears, well, the one in the spiked armor is speaking in a rather odd language. Do you have any other languages apart from common? You've not heard it before. You have heard him use it once or twice when he sort of hit his hand with his sword hilt against a stone or something like that. Quite a guttural, strong, harsh language.
Okay.
The human, dressed in fine livery, eventually says, I don't think we're going to get anything out of these people. They're quite strong-willed. I think you're wasting your time. I have a much better approach. We'll just replace one of them with one of my pets. Then it's Kachach Raloch Mora Vach Maleshach. Ha-ha! Well, it's not that hard. We do have two left. And of course, there's this new bunch, but I don't know what their story is. Well, if you don't think they're any threat, then that's fine. Then the big metal one turns, walks over to the body, kind of gives it a disdainful look, and then heads towards a large oaken door. It opens it up and disappears. The old man goes back to the body and starts stroking it.
Is there no way for me to move to another window to get a better view into the room? Are there more than one window?
Well, there's two big windows that look into this particular room that you're seeing, but you've got the perfect vantage point from here, you know? Because
I
don't think you're gonna see much more.
I want to try attune my scent and smell if the one that has been disemboweled is the Kai scent.
You won't be able to get that because there's glass in between you and it.
Okay.
Also, generally when people are disemboweled, it sticks.
Yes. But there's always that.
And you've had your nose clogged up.
Yes.
Why?
Scent of rosemary from the Kai monastery that lingers.
After three weeks.
Yeah. So then I will wait for him to leave to see if, and also looking at to see how if the window hinges and.
Windows do hinge. He doesn't look as if he's going to be leaving anytime soon, because after stroking the corpse for a while, he then goes to an array of implements on another little table and pulls out a rather large looking dagger and very neatly starts to carve chunks of flesh off of the body.
I was going to say, he is dead, the corpse.
Back to the three of you. She raises her hand and the same door that Krelok disappeared out of, he comes back again.
Yeah.
My guests wish to stay in the room that the previous Kai Lord stayed in.
My lady, I don't
show
think
them
it's
to it,
not,
please.
Fine.
Okay.
But of course.
Follow me, please. He bows to the lady. He turns and he takes you out of a different door.
Mm-hmm.